Hi, Victor here. Today I would like to share with you some guidelines when it comes to work with audio files to create your perfect video for your audience. Before I get to the very important information I am just about to share with you on this video, I want to mention that at the end of this video I will demonstrate how to work with a mix of audio files, dialogue, music and sound effects, right inside Create Studio Pro, so make sure you watch this video till the end. Thank you! As a video creator, you probably spend a lot of time trying to get most beautiful video animation possible in your projects. Then you sit down to edit the video. More time is spent on changing the colors, animating a character or a text or so on. Then it's time to move on to exporting, where you pick the perfect quality and resolution that will output your great animation. However, when it comes to audio, there's usually not much more effort put into than simply sounds good. We spend a lot of time thinking about how audio affects video production, but most of the time that's focused on the artistic side of things. Music and sound effects can help a creator add emotion, power, or energy to any project. The relationship between audio and video goes much deeper than most believe. There's also the technical side of things and how sound quality can make or break a video, regardless of how beautiful the animation is. A lot of things can go wrong when you're editing a video, but one thing we've all experienced is watching something and not being able to hear the dialogue or the music. All these issues come down to a single thing: audio levels. And when you're thinking about sound design for your next project, a great place to start is learning on how you approach audio levels for your video content. Audio is probably the most overlooked and underappreciated aspect of the animation and video process. There's a lot of debate online about the right way to level audio, but there's one thing that everyone can agree on: you should never go above 0 decibels. It is advised by virtually everyone that you should keep your audio below 0 decibels. This is because your audio will begin to clip after 0 decibels, resulting in horrible distortion. Think about it as a ceiling. As soon as your audio peaks and hits the ceiling, it will begin to get distorted. This is why explosions in Hollywood movies sound awesome, and explosions in bad YouTube videos sounds like muffled jack. Most major non-linear editing and audio editing software will have red indicators pop up anytime your audio goes above 0. If you're getting this warning, then your audio is too loud. For safety, no peaks should be above minus 6 decibels. Most video editors agree that the overall audio level of your audio mix, or your audio combined, should normalize between minus 10 decibels to minus 20 decibels. I personally level my videos around minus 12 decibels, with occasional peaks to minus 8 decibels. The trick here is to stay away from 0 decibels as best as you can. We need to keep in mind that Create Studio Pro is a professional video creation and animation software, which enables everyone to create high quality video quickly and easily. But for right now, working with audio files is limited. We all know that we don't have keyframes for the audio file in the timeline to be able to fade the volume down and up for just a few seconds somewhere in the middle of the track where we want our dialogue to stand out. So, I just found a trick to achieve just that. I will show you how to fade the music track for a certain section on the timeline so the viewer will be able to better hear the dialogue in the video and in the same time the music background to get faded. I have here on my timeline a background I got from the studio folder, and I extended its time length at a little over 1 minute and 30 seconds to match the audio file I will bring in just in few seconds. Create Studio Pro comes with a music library, a very generous one where you can find pretty much any kind of music and sound effects you might need for your video projects. You can search for a certain type of audio file by keywords, and you can also save your favorite track. So, I will just drag on the canvas this audio file from my favorites. If by any chance you don't find what you're looking for in this audio library, you might want to go and check Twinkle. Twinkle is all-in-one audio platform for creators that Create Studio team developed, where you can find premium tracks in all music genres. They offer over 500 custom-made audio tracks in all popular music genres, giving you all the variety you need. sound effects library, so you'll always have fresh new tracks to use in your videos and client videos. Royalty-free and fully licensed tracks for your peace of mind, so you can use them in unlimited personal and commercial projects as well as with clients. If you'd like to check Twinkle out, I'll leave a link in the description below. So, back to our today's example. Now that I have my audio track on the timeline and I have it selected, you can see that it has a blue outline. I want you to pay attention to this audio settings menu on the top right corner, where you can see that I am able to change the audio volume. I can fade in and... But wait, for a better understanding, let me just go here on the track and reveal the visual audio fading editing by right-click and select this edit audio fading. Now, if I bring the volume down, watch what happens on the track. I can also set a fade in and a fade out, and I can also go to the audio track itself, and once I hover my mouse over this little green dot handle, I get this cross and I can grab it and manually adjust the volume, fade in and fade out, right on the audio track. To lock this editing, you only need to right-click once again and select to hide audio fading. Now, let's bring in a voiceover I previously recorded just for this demonstration. I'll bring it here to the right and let's hear how the voiceover sounds over the music file before doing any fading editing.
Hey, this is Victor with another Create Studio Pro tutorial about how to work with audio files.
It doesn't sound good. You can barely understand what the speaker is saying because the music is too loud. What we aim is to have the music faded on the segment where the voiceover is playing. To do that, I will position the playhead right on the left edge of the voiceover track. I will select the audio file below and I will cut once. Then I will bring the playhead on the other side and do one more cut on the music file below. For the first piece of the music file, I will reveal the audio fading editing and I will have a fade out of 2 seconds. For the fade in, I will leave it 0. Let's extend the timeline a little bit and bring these two elements up here like this. Now, with a right click, let's show the edit audio fading for this track here on the right, and I'll make a 2-second fade in. I will leave the fade out and the volume as it is. For this section of the music, which is right under the voiceover track, I will reveal edit audio fading and I'm going to input a 28% volume. I'll leave the fade in and fade out at 0, and you can notice here on the track that the green wave is lower at 28%. I will want to match the point of 28% of this middle section with a point where the music track on the left would reach at approximately 28%, which will be right about here, I guess. I go on and extend the middle section of the music track a little to the left, so it will overlap the section below. I want to do the same on the other side, so I go on doing this. Now, to a better view of the sound wave of the tracks, I will close back the edit audio fading for all 3 music sections. I extend a little bit more here on the timeline, and you can see that the sound waves are not matching. So I will drag this one a little to the right, and now you can see that the little mountains, the sound waves, are matching one over another. On the other side, it is perfect. I just make it shorter a little bit. And let's hear how it sounds.
Hey, this is Victor with another Create Studio Pro tutorial about how to work with audio files.
Better demonstrate how the sound level course is going, I will reveal again the edit audio fading for all 3 music sections. And I will bring down and hold this middle section right here. Notice the path of the sound wave resulted by using this technique.
The music is fading out just before the voiceover comes in, and it fades back in just after the voiceover. Of course, you can set your own desired volume for the faded section. This is only an example on how to achieve that in Create Studio Pro. So, once that you have your music sections all set as you want, you can select all and group them together. One more thing I'd like to show you is that when we select one audio track, we have this menu on the upper right corner, and there are two sections, settings and effects. Now, going here on the effects section on the left, the only effect working on audio files is the clip speed effect. Just drag the effect on the audio track and you can see here on the right that the effect has been added. And to demonstrate how it's working, I'll input here 50%, and please notice that the length of the audio file on the timeline got longer because it will play in slow motion. This you might need when you have a slow motion scene on one of your video projects. Going back here, click on the clip speed effect, and if I type in 200%, notice that the audio file on the timeline just got shorter, which means it will play in fast forward mode. To remove the clip speed effect, you just simply click here on the X, and you get it removed, so the audio file will be back on its initial settings. So, keep in mind that for now, the only effect that can be applied to an audio file is clip speed. None of the other effects in this section is working with an audio file. If you like this tutorial, make sure you check all the videos on my channel and don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you need some ready-made templates to customize yourself inside Create Studio Pro, make sure to check out my marketplace of templates. You might find there a template to really like. As always, thank you for watching. Until next time, have fun creating!